In this learning module, you will receive an overview of the ways in which data can be accessed for analysis in the TIBCO Spotfire Analyst client. Data can be opened from flat files or added directly from database tables. However, if you are interested in data which exists in databases, you should also be made aware of the options to form connections to databases or configure information links to query data in databases. And of course, we should not omit the option to simply copy and paste data into Spotfire for analysis. Data access is a key component of any Spotfire analysis, because without data, simply put, you have nothing to analyze. And while you will build your analysis in the client application, resulting in the creation of a Spotfire analysis document, the document will either contain or reference one or more underlying data tables. So, where can you get these data tables for your analysis? The first option we will discuss is to open data from a file. There are a variety of supported file types from which Spotfire can read data, including Excel workbooks, and you don't need to worry about trying to take notes about these supported file types. I'll show you in just a minute where you can find this list within the application. However, before we perform a demonstration, you should know that there are certain expectations for how the data is formatted and organized within those file types. For example, in Excel, you must indicate which spreadsheet is to be read as a data table, and Spotfire will need to be able to interpret a row of column names and subsequent data rows from within that spreadsheet. Let's perform a quick demonstration which shows you how to access data from an Excel workbook. Here we have some data in an Excel spreadsheet. Notice that column names are listed on the first row, and a column description is listed on the second row. Below that are individual rows of data which represent purchase information for customers. This is the data we wish to analyze in Spotfire. Therefore, from an empty Spotfire session, which has no data loaded, we can either add data from this section of the welcome screen using the Open File link, or we can go to the main menu and select File Open. Please take note that it is here, in the Open File dialog, that you can view the complete list of supported file types. Let's select Microsoft Excel Workbooks and open the example with My Excel Data in the title. You can see that we are presented with an Excel import dialog, and you can see that the first row in our spreadsheet has been identified as our name row. You can also see that each column is assigned a particular data type, and we can change that data type. If, for example, we wanted the store number identifier to be treated as a string data type rather than a number, we can then click the refresh button in order to see how that impacts the data preview. Notice that the second row of descriptive information is not actually a row of data for analysis. Therefore, we can change this from a data row to a name row and again click the refresh button. That descriptive information now becomes part of the column name. If we click OK, the data is imported to become the first data table in this analysis document. A second way of accessing data for analysis is to add tables directly from databases. By default, Spotfire can open data source types using several common database drivers. In addition, other data sources may be available depending upon your installed data providers. Note, though, that the use of this approach may require that you write a SQL statement if you wish to limit data which is made available for analysis. In addition, this is generally not the recommended approach for gaining access to database data. Information links and data connections tend to be more robust options for analyzing database data, but we'll talk more about these options in a moment. First, let me show you where to find this option in the application. From the main menu, File, Add Data Tables will launch a dialog which will allow you to add a data table to your analysis. From beneath the Add button menu, you can scroll down to the section labeled Other and select the database option. After selecting the appropriate data source type, you can click the Configure button and enter the appropriate authentication information for the server and select a database. After navigating to the data of interest, you could limit data by entering custom SQL statements here, or not. Then, after giving the data source a name, clicking OK and clicking OK will make that data available for analysis. Specific in-database data connectors present another option for gaining access to data in databases. There is an ever-growing list of cube and relational database sources which are supported with data connectors. So it's best to check the system requirements page on the Spotfire support website in order to view the complete list of data sources which are currently available for this data access option. The use of these data connectors is the only way in which you may perform an analysis where the data remains external. This in-database analysis approach means that calculations are performed within the data source rather than Spotfire's in-memory data engine. If you prefer not to analyze data in-database, for relational database types, you have the option to import the data to be handled as an in-memory data table. In addition, data connections contain information about the data table selected for analysis, structural relations, joins, and cache settings, as well as data source details like the URL, server name, port number, database name, and user credentials. These details can be saved either as part of the analysis document or saved to the Spotfire library. Let's take a look at a very brief demonstration. Again, using the File Add Data Table menu option, you may use the Add Button menu drop-down list in order to locate the Connection To section. Scroll in order to find the data source of interest, like Teradata, and enter the required server and authentication information. Then, select a database. You can select a table or tables from the resulting database schema, which use existing relations, or even form your own relations using this dialog. After clicking OK, this is where you have the option, independently for each data table, to keep the data external or import the data table. And again, we have that database data available in Spotfire for analysis. As mentioned, we have the option to save the data connection settings information to the Spotfire library, as well as the data source settings information, such that other Spotfire users would be able to more easily gain access to this database data. Another way to access data in databases is to configure information links. Information links are database queries which are created using the Spotfire server. These queries are SQL-based. However, the information designer creates these queries with a series of graphical user interface dialogues, so no knowledge of the SQL language is required in order to create information links. Information links are stored within the server library and are particularly useful when designing data access for others because they can be designed to limit data queried, perform joins between different database tables, and apply conditioning steps like data pivoting, which is all invisible to the user. User input can also be gathered through the use of prompts, which allow a single information link to be used to query different data, depending upon the user's response to the prompts you present. Again, I will perform a quick demonstration, which will show you how a simple information link may be a useful data access option. If you have appropriate permissions, you can access from the Tools menu the option which will launch the Information Designer, assuming that database elements have already been mapped as an information model on the Spotfire server. We can navigate this folder structure in the library in order to expose the elements of interest and create an information link. We may select a series of columns to include in the table, like date joined, business location, and total purchase amount. Then we can create a prompt, which allows the user to indicate for the total column a select range of values. If we save this to a specific folder on the library as My Information Link, when we close the Information Designer and imagine ourselves in the role of the user, we can return once again to the File Add Data Tables menu option, and this time from the Add Button drop-down menu, we will select Information Link. We must navigate to the folder containing My Information Link, select it, and click OK. Notice that we are presented with a prompt dialog which allows us to enter a range for the database query. For this example, we will restrict our query to customers who have made total purchase amounts between $5,000 and $25,000. When we click Finish and click OK, the database is queried and another new data table is added to our analysis. Scrolling to the bottom of the filters reveals that the data table rows fall within our range of $5,000 to $25,000, according to our response to the information link prompt. In addition to these options for adding new data tables, you also have the ability to use those same options in order to merge data from other sources to existing data tables in your analysis, using the menu options available to insert columns or insert rows. Note that this option is presented for data connections only when the existing data table has been imported to be handled as in-memory data. Returning to our demonstration example, the Insert menu is where you will find both the ability to add rows and the ability to add columns to an existing data table. If we select Insert Columns, we can choose to which of the existing data tables the new columns should be added. Then take note that the Select button dropdown provides the same list of options which are available under the Add button dropdown in the Add Data Tables dialog. For this example, we will select File and choose the Excel workbook with My Customer Data in the title. When we click Open, you can see a preview of the available data, and completing this process will add each customer's age and gender to the data table resulting from my original Excel data. In addition to these options for obtaining data for analysis, there is one more way in which you can provide data for analysis in Spotfire. If you copy data in the appropriate format to your clipboard, you can either paste it into the analysis or add it from the clipboard. Let's take a look at one more very short demonstration. Here we have a table of interest in a Word document. We could highlight the data in this table and copy it to our clipboard. Then return to Spotfire and go to File, Add Data Tables. And beneath the Add button drop-down menu, you will find the Clipboard option. Selecting this option presents the Import Settings dialog, where we can get a preview of the table before clicking OK and clicking OK in order to add that data table to our Spotfire analysis document. Finally, our list of data access options reflects a comprehensive overview of the ways in which data can be accessed for analysis in the TIBCO Spotfire Analyst client.